our first category is arithmetic and mathematical functions. It means in this category we only carry or we only consider those functions which are performing any kind of mathematical operation. Our first function is sum function. And as from the name it is very clear, this function is generally used to add the values. ये function क्या करेगा? ये values को या numbers को add करने का काम करेगा. So now let's read the description part. It is used to add the values or add all the numbers in the specified range of cells. इसका basic काम क्या होता है भाई? It is generally used to add the numbers in the given range of cells. And this function is written like this. ये इसका syntax given है. That is equals to sum a1 colon a5. अब ये जो a1 colon a5 है, फाइन, ये जो a1 colon a5 है, ये यहाँ पे एक डेमो रेंज दी हुई है. हमेशा यही नहीं लिखना है हम लोगों को. ये रेंज हमारे क्वेश्चन में चेंज होती जाएगी हर बार, बट यहाँ पे मैंने एग्जांपल के लिए एक रेंज लिखा हुआ है, दैट इज a1 colon a5. इट सिंपली शोज दैट यू हैव टू राइट अ सेल रेंज. देन आर सेकेंड फंक्शन इज प्रोडक्ट फंक्शन. वेल, दिस प्रोडक्ट फंक्शन इज जनरली यूज टू मल्टीप्लाई द गिवन वैल्यूज. फाइन, इट इज यूज टू कैलकुलेट द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द नंबर्स इन द स्पेसिफाइड रेंज ऑफ सेल्स. सो व्हाट दिस फंक्शन विल डू, it will simply multiply the numbers which you have given in the selected range. And for example, if you have written equals to product a1 colon a5, it will be your product function. And this will return you the multiplication of all these numbers. Then our next function is sqrt. Sqrt stands for square root. It stands for square root, so you have to remember the full form also. This function is generally used to calculate the square of the numbers. Let's suppose you got a number that is 625, and let's suppose in any condition or any criteria you have to calculate the square root of this number. You have to calculate the square root of this number. Fine. So either you have to learn all these numbers, or what you can do, you can directly use the square root function and it will give the result as 25. Or let's suppose you have a number as 2401, you have to calculate the square root. तो माइट भी अगर याद नहीं होगा, इट विल ऑटो कैलकुलेट ऑटोमेटिकली कैलकुलेट द स्क्वायर रूट एज 49. फाइन, सो वी कैन यूज दी स्क्वायर रूट फंक्शंस टू कैलकुलेट द स्क्वायर रूट वैल्यूज. सिंटेक्स इज वेरी सिंपल. इन दिस फंक्शन वी डोंट नीड टू पास एनी सेल रेंज, वी जस्ट हैव टू राइट आर सिंगल सेल एड्रेस. देन आवर नेक्स्ट फंक्शन इज पावर फंक्शन. पावर फंक्शन इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन इन एम एस एक्सेल. वेल, इट इज जनरली यूज टू कैलकुलेट द रिजल्ट ऑफ नंबर रेज टू अ गिवन पावर. Now suppose you are performing any kind of mathematical functions and you have to calculate this. Let's say 12 to power 3. Fine. Suppose you have to calculate 12 raised to the power 3 and let's say you don't know what will be the output. So in that case, what we have to do, in MS Excel we can write it like this. We will write equals to power. Then here our number is 12, comma power is 3. So you have to write equals to power 12, 3 in the brackets, and then you have to press the enter key. The moment when you will press the enter key, it will give the result. Then our next function is round function. This round function is used to round off the number or round off the value up to the specified number of digits. Let's take an example. Suppose I have a number as 3.1437435. Now let's suppose I have to round off this number up to 2 digits of decimal. Fine, let's suppose I have to round off this number up to 2 digits of decimal. Then for that I'll write my function as equals to round, then this number, that is 3.1437435, 2. Now here this number will be our input value and this 2 will be the number of decimals that we want in our answer, and it will give you a result as 3.14. So all these functions are termed as mathematical functions. Then our next category is string functions. And in the string functions, as I've told you right now, these functions work on your text. ये work करते हैं हमारे text पे, यानी कि वो textual matter जो हम लोग type कर रहे हैं, which can be anyone's name, address, email ID or something. Fine. So whenever we have to apply any kind of effect on these values, we use the string functions. Now our first function is left function. Let's take a scenario first of all. Let's take an example first. Suppose we have a word computer. Now you got a question. Somebody told you that fetch 3 characters from the starting of this word. Or let's say we have one more question that somebody is asking the two characters from the end. Now, when we talk about the starting, it means from this side, it will be the start, as well as this side will be the left side also. If we talk about this side, this will be the end of this word, and this side will also be termed as the right side of this word, and rest of this portion, rest of all these characters will be in the middle of the starting and end. So it will be a part of our mid function. Suppose we have one more question here that somebody is asking us to fetch one character written after second character. Fine. What they have said, we have three cases here. Our first case is saying fetch three characters from the starting. Second is saying fetch two characters from the end. And third is saying fetch one character written after second character. Now let's see what we have to do for this. So now what we will do, I'm writing this whole again so that I can only focus on this word computer. Our first question was to fetch three characters from start. Now, for this first statement, our formula or our function will be like this. We will write equals to left. Then let's say we have written this word in A1. Find the cell address of this word is A1. So we will write A1, comma, 3. So when you will write A1 comma 3, the output of this particular function will be COM. It means it will calculate the first three characters of your word. Second case was saying that we have to calculate two characters from end. As I've told you right now, this end means the right hand side. Fine. So for this, our function will be equals to write. And we will write A1 comma 2, and this will give you the result as ER, because our last two characters are E and R. And our third statement was saying there is first character after second character. So it was saying that you have to fetch the first character written just after the second character of the string. So what we have to do for this, we will use the mid function. We will write equals to mid. Then we have to pass our string, that is A1. Now what they are saying, ki bhai hum logon ko second wale character se fetch karna hai, yani iske aage se check karna hai. Second character ye wala O hai, is O ke aage se check karna hai. So we will write 2 comma 1. So ye wala jo 2 hai, ye bata raha hai ki kiske aage se check karna, starting karni hai hum logon ko. और वन बता रहा है कि कितने कैरेक्टर्स वहां से बाहर निकालने हैं. फाइन. सो इट विल बी मिड A1 कॉमा 2 कॉमा 1 एंड द आउटपुट विल बी M. इट मींस दिस वाला. फाइन. नाउ लेट्स रीड दिस थ्री क्विकली. फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज लिफ्ट एंड इट इज सेइंग दैट इट इज यूज्ड टू रिटर्न सप्लाइड और स्पेसिफाइड नंबर ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द नंबर. सो स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग. The syntax will be equals to left text, the number of characters that we have to fetch. Then our second function is write function, and it is used to return the specified number of characters from the end or from the right side of your supplied text string. And the syntax will be equals to write text comma number of characters. Then our third function is mid function. This mid function is used to return the specified number of characters from the middle of the supplied text string. And the syntax will be equals to mid text comma starting number comma number of characters that we have to fetch. Then our next function will be lower function. This lower function is the most important part. Well, let's take an example once more, and this will be on this upper, lower and proper. Suppose we have a sentence.
Hello students.
हाउ आर यू. सो सपोज वी हैव दिस पर्टिकुलर सेंटेंस. वेल एज यू कैन सी इन दिस सेंटेंस, दिस एच इज कैपिटल, दिस एस इज कैपिटल, दिस एच इज कैपिटल एंड दिस वाई इज कैपिटल. सो वी हैव टोटल फोर कैप्स एंड रिमेनिंग इन द स्मॉल केस ओनली. सो नाउ लेट सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू राइट द होल थिंग इन द कैपिटल लेटर्स ओनली. लेट सपोज इट इज रिटन इन सेल A1. सपोज करते हैं ये पूरा का पूरा हम लोगों ने स्ट्रिंग लिखा हुआ है, सेल A1 में लिखा हुआ है ये. तो भाई अगर हम लोगों को पूरे को कैपिटल में लिखना है, वी वॉन्ट टू राइट दिस होल इन द कैप्स दैट इज इन द अपर केस, देन फॉर दैट वी हैव टू राइट इक्वल्स टू अपर A1. When you will write this, you will get the output something like this. Hello? Students? How are you? Fine, it means if in case you are using this upper function, everything will appear in the capital letters or in the upper case. Now let's suppose we want to write the things in the lower case. We want to write our string in the lower case. For that, we will use the lower function. We will write equals to lower A1. And the output will be very simple. It will be this. Hello, students. How are you? Fine. So it means when you are using the lower case, everything will appear in the small case only. And let's think about the English grammar. So whenever in English grammar we initiate any sentence, we just have to write our first letter in the caps. It means if we are talking about this particular sentence, to is wale sentence mein only this H needs to be capital. Baki sare letters are small mein hone chahiye because the sentence continuation mein hai. So for that, what we can use proper case, we can use proper function. We will write proper case now. For that, our function will be like this. We have to write equals to proper A1. And output will be very simple. Your first letter will be in the caps. And remaining will be in small. Now let's read these three. Fine. Quickly have a look at this and then we have to read these three. So first function is lower function. It is used to convert the characters in the lower case. Syntax is this side, that is lower and then your text. Then next function is upper function. This upper function is generally used to convert the characters in the upper case. Syntax is written over this side, this is upper then text. And then our next function is proper function. This proper function is generally used to convert the characters or your string or your sentence in the proper case, which means your first word will be in the capital. Fine, the first letter of the first word will be in the capital, whereas rest of the letters of that sentence will be in the small case. And here's the syntax of this. So today we have discussed about two categories. Our first category was arithmetic functions. Our second category was string functions. In our coming class, we have to discuss about statical functions, then logical functions, and then we have to try all these practically, and then you will have a revision test. So just start preparing for the revision test. Fine. Till then, keep learning.